be associated with the people.
Yeah.
They think they know them, that's why they do that, yet they don't.
Thank you very much. That's a very important point. We are here, we may think we know all about LGBTI, but we don't. We just know ourselves. Anybody else want to say why we get this flip flop?
Maybe somebody just fear to be criticized.
Fear of criticism. Okay, thank you very much. Yes, madam.
Some don't want to achieve their goals.
Some want to achieve their goals, yeah. Okay. Anybody else? Okay. Now, thank you very much, everyone. What I'd like us to maybe agree or to understand. You know, we're all here for different purposes. Some want to achieve their goals, this. It's fine. But we don't want to be carriers of discrimination in our lives. Because some of your children may be gay. And your brothers and your sisters and goodness knows what. Are we together? So we don't want to be people carrying this virus of homophobia. Because we did not understand what it's all about. We never took time to understand really what is a gay person. What do they feel? What do they experience? You know? So, and then, you know, in Uganda we have this hypocrisy. Because people, you know, everyone is saying we don't want gay people, so they are gay. Many of the people who are saying it are also gay. But they would never give themselves that label. They don't want to be labeled, but they want to do it. Secretly or hidden or whatever. But then when they come out, you know. And we have many people who are married, but actually their sexual orientation is not heterosexual. They may be bisexual, or they may be what we call closet gays. You know? There are many people who just get married because they want to cover up their sexual orientation. Okay, that's the society we live in. So I'm just trying to sensitize us to this. Let's be very sensitive, because we come from a community which is homophobic, and we may find that we ourselves, we are carrying some of that. We may have some feelings or attitudes which are really not right. You know, this issue of gay or homosexuality has now become a political issue. It's no longer a simple issue, it's actually a political issue. And for me, I was extremely pleased. I was very happy when, you know the story as we have been told. The bill was passed on February 26th this year. And everybody said, hey, hello, wonderful, Pastor Semba, and all his mom. And after the bill was signed, they all went to Kololo, and they had a big celebration. And they brought in children, and, you know, carrying banners, michi. They were so happy. And of course, after that, what happened? Many people took the law into their own hands. People began to be victimized. Gay people were being victimized. And that's why I told you there are 170 LGBTI refugees now in Nairobi, in Kenya. Some are in the camps. They came there after February. And there are more leaving every day. When the bill was passed, there is a young man who went to the police station, and he said, you see that Father Musaala and all the people in his house, they have sodomized me. Yeah. And he went to the police station in Kasangati, near where I come from, and he made this report, and you know, I found out about it through other means, and I went to the police station to find out what was going on. And they said, oh yes, Father Musaala, we have to take this very seriously, because there's a lot of homosexuality in Uganda now. And we hear you're one of the promoters.